Okay, what's going on everybody? My name is Matrix and I want to welcome you guys today to a video that I actually asked you guys if you wanted to see, and we got an overwhelming level of support. So with that being said everybody, I am going to be showing you guys today how you can use this racing wheel, or honestly any racing wheel or controller or anything, actually, to basically play Roblox with whatever, with anything other than a keyboard. You could use a controller, like an Xbox controller, like I have right here. You could use this right here, which is a Logitech racing wheel. You could use literally anything other than your keyboard, and I'm gonna show you guys how to today. So, first of all, here we are on the channel, and I just wanna say really, really quickly, guys, thank you so much. I'm gonna click on the video right now, so I'm gonna pause that ad. So, I ask you guys for some really crazy like goal of 2,000 likes. If we hit 2,000 likes, I said I would show you guys this video, and look at this! Look at this, we're at 2,500 likes! Just crazy, guys. Just absolutely crazy. So, I know it's taken me 2 weeks to do this, but I have a lot of videos planned with the racing wheel, and I will be doing them shortly, guys, so stay tuned. Other than that, though, let's go ahead and get started, guys. So, thank you again, lastly, for all the support. I honestly don't know what to think of it. If you guys want to see, actually, this is a really good idea. If you guys want to see a very, very, very special roleplay series with the racing wheel in Ultimate Driving, this video has to break the last video. And the last video got 2,500 likes. Can we break that? I don't know. But if we can, I promise you guys a really cool roleplay series using this racing wheel. Okay? Other than that, let's get started. So, this is the website here. First link in the description. Click that link. It'll bring you to this website. And this is Joy2Key. Joy2Key is a really easy website to work with, so we're gonna go ahead and get into it. There's a download link right at this tab right here. You just gotta click download. It's pretty straightforward. And I guess right here it says download the latest version, so I would just click the first link, I guess, and there you go. So it's downloading right now, and you guys can see that. Okay, good. I'm gonna go ahead and click it. You guys may need this program here called WinRAR. I'm gonna leave a link to that underneath it as well. I don't know if you need it. You might not, but if you do, it'll be there. And we just really need to open up this software right here, and that's it. It took 2 seconds, and this right here, guys. Now I know it looks really intimidating. I know it looks like there's a lot of stuff here, but it's really not that hard to use. So let's think about it for a second, okay? First off, you want to make sure that this system right here, Joy2Key, knows that you have a racing wheel attached or an Xbox controller, whatever it is. So click this right here, configure game controller, and see, it says right here, Logitech G920 Driving Force Racing Wheel. It knows that it's there. So I'm going to click OK. It already knows that it's there, guys. We're going to go ahead and hit OK again. And now watch this. This is what you're going to have to do in order to bind all of your keys. So, for example, if I want to know what exactly, well, it's shorted. Thanks for just popping up now. But basically, if I wanted to know if I was turning left, all I need to do is turn my racing wheel left and see how this is highlighted now. This right here, turning left, activates stick one. It activates this right here. If I turn right, it activates that. So what you need to do is basically click edit this button assignment. You're going to right click, and since that turned it left, I just have to press A. So now whenever I go like this and I turn left, it's gonna press the A button, okay? You guys can basically bind every single one of these. We're gonna go ahead and do it really quickly. So this would be D. And then another cool thing, I have pedals down below. You guys can't see them, but let me show you. As you can see, I'm pressing the gas pedal and it's telling me to go forward. So we are gonna bind that to the W key. Go ahead and hit OK. So yeah, you guys got left and right and forward, and now you also got stop right here. Let me get this off. And now you got stop. So you got left. So you got everything bound. Everything looks good. And you can actually go a lot more than this. Like, I did it for my video. You can go really, really crazy with this. Like, for instance, if you wanted to have your turn signals work, what you could do is, for instance, if I wanted my paddle shifters to be my turn signals, I know that this button number 6, is going to be for my turn signal. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to bind that to the Z key. Now the Z key in Ultimate Driving turns on my left blinker. So now if I want my right blinker, I just have to find what button it is. Okay, it's button number 5. I am going to bind that to my C key. And now there you go. Now you got your signals as well. And there's other things you could do as well. Like if I wanted my headlights to work, I'm pressing the Y button on my keyboard. or on my controller, sorry. So now we're gonna go ahead and we are gonna bind this to our headlights, which I think is H or is it L? I don't know, but we're gonna go with H. And that's as easy as it is, guys. It's not that complicated. You could do that with your controller like in a minute or like 2 minutes tops. So yeah, that's it. That's all you gotta do. So now we're gonna go ahead, head on into Roblox, guys. I'll meet you there and I'll show you guys how this works. Alrighty, guys, so we're now inside of Ultimate Driving. You are gonna see some lag here. I still haven't figured out how to work OBS to where it doesn't lag when I use the racing wheel, but it just does, and I'm sorry, but to show you guys some gameplay so you know it's legit, we're gonna go ahead and get started. Do mind the lag because there is gonna be some, but let's get started. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on my screen here, and so as you can see, we are going. I'm only pressing, you can see my hands, right? I'm not pressing anything but the but the gas pedal. So let's back up now. I do need to use the racing wheel to back up. But yeah, so we're taking off here, guys, and it's honestly a really pretty cool experience. I'm not gonna lie. You can still see that the sensitivity isn't really tuned to the way I want it to be, but it's actually not that bad. If you're like really, really light with the steering wheel, it's pretty good just as it is. I might do an advanced tutorial video if that's something you guys wanna see in the future for basically like how to fine tune it so it's even better. But we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna go here, and you can see it's really, it's not like ideal, I would say, but it's really a fun experience, and for what it's worth, I think it's worth it. Don't mind the squeaking. I need to get something fixed in this racing wheel. I don't know what it is that's causing that squeaking, but I'm gonna get that fixed at some point. But yeah, so look at this, guys. It's actually not bad. I'm only using one hand. It's pretty easy to steer with. Okay, look away for 1 second and that's what happens. That's another button I could bind, the flip button. But yeah, so I wanted to show you a couple of other things around here. Let's go over to Westover very, very quickly, and I'm gonna go ahead, pull over in a parking lot, and show you guys the rest of the features that I have right now. There's a bunch you can add. A cool one, actually. Oh, you know what a really cool one would be? Hold on a second, let me stop the car. Stop the car, stop everything. I got a really cool one to show you, okay? So we're gonna go here, and I'm actually gonna bind my drift button. So if we go here and we press B, like this, now I have a drift button, okay? So watch what happens now when I press B. So we're gonna go up here like this, pick up some speed, forget that the steering wheel is super sensitive, but watch this, guys. We're gonna go around this corner, and we can literally drift anywhere we want now, guys. It's pretty cool. It's, that's probably my favorite thing about this, is being able to drift. But yeah, so we can stop right here. I'll just stop the car. And just to show you guys the last of the few things here, we have the turn signal. So if I go ahead and, like you saw, I press the paddle shifter, it does turn on my turn signal. And if I do the right one, it does the exact same thing. And then the last one I have bound right now, guys, is my headlights. So if it gets night out, I can actually just press Y and turn on my headlights while I'm driving. So it's a really nice little feature to have. But that's basically it, guys. That's the whole tutorial. If you guys want an advanced tutorial, just let me know. Also, if you guys want to see a roleplay using this, let me know as well. Okay, guys, take it easy, everybody. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Let me know if you have any problems. I will try to help as many of you as I can. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I will see you all in the next video.